If you see, the official syllabus is very simple. It has given only these five lines: sustainable development, poverty, inclusion, demographic. So this is not sufficient to really decipher what is the syllabus of the UPSC. So best approach will be to look for the previous year question. So if you see the previous year question, these are some of the component: the basic national income and inflation. Then we have money and banking chapter, budget, taxation and fiscal sector, foreign sector, agriculture, industry, services, infrastructure, social sector. So if out of this, you know which chapters are the heart and soul of the entire paper, I can say these four areas: the money and banking, budget, taxation, fiscal sector, foreign sector. These are the heart and soul, right? And yes, we can also say social sector. Rather, we will say the government schemes. If we include the government scheme also, then we can say yes, this is heart of the syllabus, because questions will be repeating from these areas only. And yes, there is a repetition of question, the same concept they are repeating again and again. So let us see some of the dimensions of the syllabus: microeconomy or macroeconomy. So which is the syllabus of UPSC? This is the macroeconomy. Yes, certain times they ask the question of microeconomy, but for that we cannot devote any time, because if there is some difficult question, then it is difficult for everyone, and for that we can't read a whole together new book. The syllabus is macroeconomy only. Then we have both current and static, so it is very difficult to segregate. We cannot really say whether the question is from the current or the static. So whenever we are reading the current affairs, we have to look for the concept of that particular topic. And similarly, when we are when we are reading the static portion also, then we have to try and see what is the current affair news of the particular concept. So it is really difficult to segregate. Okay, theory and application. This application part is very, very important. They will not ask the question which is direct question. They will ask the question where you need to apply your mind. So in 2020, they asked the question about this money supply in the economy, right? 1 lakh rupees withdrawal from the bank. That is a perfect example of now they are going for the application part. So we have these dimensions. We have to keep in mind these dimensions. Now, if we see the previous year question, most of the questions, they are coming from again these areas, these six areas we can say: the basics, banking, fiscal policy, external sector, government scheme. And yes, this is also one of the area: international organizations, right? And these are the areas which are less important: the population, Indian agriculture. Yes, Indian agriculture is now becoming important. Now they are mixing the questions from the geography and economy and environment, and that is how they are putting one statement in a question from the economy, one statement from the environment, statement from the geography. So from that perspective, yes, we can see some of the questions in the economy also. Otherwise, if we see population, yes, there are very less questions. Planning, yes, they are asking the questions from the planning sector since last 2 years. And financial markets, yes, they are asking maybe one question. This time also they asked one question. So one each question. So and two questions from here and zero questions from here. This was the trend of the 2020, right? Yes. So the point is, even if these topics are less important, still we cannot ignore this topic. We have to go through the basic concept. And yes, the questions in this topic are less conceptual as compared to the earlier topic, right? And these questions are mostly direct questions. So if you are aware about just the basics, just the important concepts, then it is sufficient to master these topic. Okay, so we have segregated the topic into two categories. One category is which is very, very important, and they are asking the questions again and again from this area. In this area, the questions they're asking highly conceptual, application oriented, and they are current affairs oriented, right? And these questions are really, we need to master this subject in very, very detail, right? So we have to differentiate the topic which we have to focus, which we don't have to focus. Now, what is the step-by-step approach? How should we follow then approach where we can really get to the source? First is previous year question. This previous year question should be analyzed topic wise. Okay. So suppose you start the chapter of money and banking. So what you will do, first you will go through all the previous year question which have been asked from that particular chapter. And you will just read the question. You will not solve the question. You will not apply your mind. The purpose is just to be familiar with the type of question which are being asked so that you are attentive when you are reading your study material or class PPT. Then building the foundation. This concept building is very, very important. In the first reading, or even if you are revising, always keep thinking how this is going to impact various aspects. For example, if there is increase in the money supply, how it is going to impact the inflation, how it is going to impact the foreign exchange rate, how it is going to impact the poor person, how it is going to impact the agriculture sector. Just try to, you know, keep thinking. For example, what is the impact of corona? If during the corona, the government came up with the policy of expansionist fiscal and monetary policy, what is the implication on the poor people? What is the implication on the inflation? Right? So you have to just, you know, keep thinking, try to interlink. What will happen if the government puts more money into the infrastructure sector? How it is impact the poverty? How will it impact the jobs, right? So we need to, you know, interlink, and we need to understand the concept. If we keep doing this, I am telling you 50% of the questions we can solve, right? 50% of the questions nowadays, they are asking in a manner where you have to be conceptually very, very thorough. You cannot cram the concept. That is what I want to say. You cannot cram any book. I cannot give you any book and I can't say that you cram this book and you are done. No, that is not supposed to be done. 50% of the questions you can solve only if you have the conceptual clarity. Are you getting? Then application of the concept in the current affair, right? As I told you, if there is a COVID situation, or, you know, there was a concept of V-shaped recovery in the economy, then there was a concept of, say, counter-cyclical fiscal policy. I have discussed both of these things in the economic survey lectures, which I have taken. So you have to be, application oriented, and you have to look into what are the new keywords coming up in the economy, right? क्या क्या नए words हैं जो economy में आ रहे हैं, हमें उनको देखते रहना होगा, और उनका मतलब क्या है वो हमें देखते रहना होगा. There are certain concepts which are that much important, but once they become into the current affairs, they become important. For example, this year economic survey, it says a term fiscal slippage, right? So why this fiscal slippage? Because the government has spent more than its capacity, and the target which is set at the start of the year last year, the target it set for the fiscal deficit last year, that target is being violated because of the COVID. So there is a fiscal slippage. We are diverting, we are violating the target. Okay. So this fiscal slippage concept is in news, right? Similarly, real income versus national income, real income versus nominal income. This is also in news in the economic survey. So there are certain concepts which are highlighted, which are put emphasis upon, and we have to understand those concepts. And I can tell you, you will be thorough. I mean, economy is such a wonderful subject. I can say it is very, very easy subject if we compare it with other subject. Okay. I really feel very, very happy when I see the questions of the economy. It gives some food for the mind, and it's a pleasure to solve the economic questions. If you are really comfortable in the economy, you would like to go back and see the UPSC questions, and you will be happy. Yeah, I'm really enjoying this exercise. Are you getting? So that is possible only when you have a conceptual bent of mind. And for that, there is no shortcut. Okay. There is no shortcut. I can tell you, no single book can solve your problem. Okay. No, you have to apply your mind. You have to have a guide. That one, then only you can do. Revision, definitely. There is no shortcut. And for this revision, you should have some crux notes where you don't need to read entire material. Rather, you can just go back to the notes, look into the key aspect, and move further, right? So don't get stuck. And finally, there is no alternative to the multiple choice question practice. The more you practice, the better you become in increasing the accuracy, right? So all of this is required, and I know that you already know about these things, but the point is, are you really doing this? And most importantly, are you looking the concept from the application point of view? Are you sitting down, taking some time and really trying to interlink various things? And if you're struggling somewhere, ask me, okay? You are free to ask the questions. I'll give my ID to you, and you are free to ask the questions to me. I am very, very happy to solve your economy related queries. I can come up with separate doubt clearing sessions on the economy, because economy is such a pleasure for me. I really enjoy teaching economy, reading economy, solving the questions on the economy, right? I'm not saying that I am the master blaster of economy, but yeah, it's really something which I enjoy, right? So are you clear about this? Any doubt in this? I think this is something which is already, you know, most of you already know. Now we will come to the real thing, and we will see the previous year questions, the pattern of the previous year questions, right? And in the previous year questions, there are various categories of questions. Some questions based upon the definition, questions based upon the concept, upon the data and facts, government schemes, organizations, report ranking. So these are the five, six categories where the questions are being asked. Mostly jo questions hote hain wo in any category ke andar aapko puche jayenge, ya to ye directly aapki definition puch lenge. Jaise ki yahan par capital adequacy ratio, ye direct question hai aapka, theek hai? To direct question hai yahan par, you know, agar aapko definition pata hai to aap isko aaram se solve kar sakte ho, theek hai? Then another type of question is this conceptual question, right? Conceptual question mein they are asking from the money and banking कि रेपो रेट बढ़ेगा तो क्या इंपैक्ट होगा, बैंक रेट बढ़ेगा तो क्या इंपैक्ट होगा, अगर एक्सचेंज रेट डेप्रिशिएट करता है तो उसका इंपैक्ट क्या होगा. हर एक चैप्टर के अंदर दे आर आस्किंग मल्टीपल क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर कॉन्सेप्चुअल. इवन इन द एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर दिस इज द कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन. यू कैन सी कि हाउ द प्राइसेस ऑफ द राइस आर impacted. This is the question of 2020, right? So, you know, if we think about each of these options, and I'll come and discuss these things in detail after some time in today's session only. So if we really go through and see the questions, you know, the questions are very, very logical, conceptual, right? Data and fact based question. Suppose this question, this question is based upon the trained data and trained. Most of the India's external debt is owned by the government entities. So most of them means majority, all of the India's external debt is denominated in US dollar, all, right? So the question is based upon the trend, right? Here we are not supposed to remember the facts. What we are supposed to do is to have really an idea of important trends or important you can say data, right? We don't have to mug up, but if we really are interested in various aspects, then it becomes very natural for us. We don't have to remember these. ठीक है? तो हमें याद रखने की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ती है. हमें automatically चीज़ें जो हैं वो हम याद कर लेते हैं. ठीक है? उसके बाद आता है government scheme. Government scheme are very, very integral part of the economy, right? Again, the questions are direct questions, and if you are well aware about the important features of the economy, important features of the scheme, then it is done. अभी स्कीम के अंदर आपको एक चीज ध्यान रखनी होगी. नॉट ऑल द स्कीम्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट. दोज स्कीम्स विच आर फ्लैगशिप स्कीम्स और विच आर न्यूज, जो सक्सेसफुल स्कीम है, मोस्टली दोज स्कीम्स विच आर सक्सेसफुल, दोज आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड यू आर सपोज टू गो थ्रू इन मोर डिटेल स्टडी ऑफ दोज स्कीम. इफ देर इज सम न्यू स्कीम विच इज अनाउंस्ड इन द बजट, यू आर नॉट सपोज टू गो इन टू द डिटेल. यू जस्ट हैव टू सी ओके वाट आर द what is the purpose of the scheme, which ministry is running this, and who are the beneficiaries. Just 2-3 aspects you can see for the new scheme. But for the old schemes, for example Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, for example this National Food Security Act or Kisan Credit Card, once it is in news, once it is a successful scheme, then you have to really get into the depth of this scheme, because they will ask some difficult questions from this, right? Then international organizations. Now this international organizations again are very important, and again the questions are not very, very factual. But if you are reading the international organizations with a analytical mindset, then it is easy to solve the questions. National organizations, now they are asking the question from this area also. For example, PNGRB, right? So again, in this type of question, even if we are not aware about the answer, but if we try with the elimination technique, intelligent guessing, then we can solve the questions, right? Now, another question is report type of question. They're asking the report, who is publishing this report? So for that, again, it is a factual question. We can remember these things, right? So primarily, what are the sources of the questions? Either the questions are the very, very basic question, but very conceptual also. You have to solve these questions with the help of your conceptual understanding. Current affairs questions, for example, if MSP is in news, they will ask the question from the MSP directly or indirectly, right? Or economic survey. In the economic survey also, we can say 2 to 3 questions they are asking. But you are not supposed to go through economic survey like a scholar. You are not supposed to do the research on the economic survey. Maximum, you have to spend 10 to 15 hours, right? And we are offering free course on the economic survey, and that is more than sufficient. You just attend those 10, 12 hours of lecture and revise them twice. I don't think and you will miss anything from the economic survey. And more than that, there is no requirement of studying the economic survey. You are not supposed to be the master of the economic survey. Now, there are certain techniques which you should know regarding solving the MCQ. So, kya technique hongi? Elimination technique, aapko sabko pata hai, elimination technique. Intelligent guessing, extreme statement ko dekhna, common sense, ye to bahut zaruri hai, theek hai? Aaj ke samay mein main bolunga ki kam padho, lekin common sense ko jyada apply karo. Stop overthinking and stop doing unnecessary analysis, rather apply your common sense, especially in those questions which you feel are very, very tricky, right? And last, identifying the questions which are to be left. This is the most important part, I will say, because you should not take the questions on your ego. Ki yaar, economy ka question hai, aur main commerce ka student hoon, main nahi solve karunga, to kaun solve karega? Bhai, izzat ka sawal hai. Nahi, aisa nahi sochna hai. Theek hai? Aapko question padhna hai, apna status dekhna hai. Are you able to solve it or not? Are you able to apply elimination technique, intelligent guessing? Or if you are not able to solve, leave the question. Don't take this on your ego, right? Ego pe mat lijiye. Question chhodna hai to chhodiye. Koi problem nahi hai. But you should know what to leave. Because deciding that I will not attempt this question is also a decision. The UPSC is looking for the decision maker. They are not looking for the PhD scholars. Otherwise, they will make PhD as the basic qualification. They are not looking for the PhD people. They are looking for the people who know how to make the decision based upon the circumstances. So in case you are not feeling comfortable in any question, despite a lot of practice, despite a lot of revision, then you should leave the question. So these are also some of the things you should remember, right? Prelims 2020 overview, we will be doing very, very soon. Then chapter wise analysis, we will be doing this chapter wise analysis. We will be doing throughout the week as we go with this prelims marathon. So today evening, for example, we will do some of the analysis from the money and monetary policy, previous year trend analysis, some MCQ analysis we will do in the evening, right? Now, step-by-step approach, I have told you, book kya honi chahiye? Book mein to sabko pata hai, aap ye do book pad lijiye, kam se kam, you must remember at least these two books you should go through, theek hai? And Indian economy ke liye, abhi, you can, there is a new book, Nitin Singhania, you can follow that book also, right? But the problem in the books is that, they take a lot of time to update, right? Because they are releasing the edition after 1 year. So in case you have joined some classes or you plan to join some classes, it is better to refer to the class notes, because the class notes are very, very comprehensive and they are designed in an exam oriented manner. The problem with the standard books, for example, Ramesh Singh, the problem is that they try to cater to various exam, and for that they try to include irrelevant thing. So there are lot of outdated, irrelevant thing, and you know, in the process you get more confused. You are not able to identify what is important, what is not important. चलिए, तो अभी हम बात करते हैं. Let us see some of the things. What kind of MCQ practice should be done? First, you should do the practice based upon the NCRT. In case you have not done the NCRT based practice, right? Topic wise conceptual MCQ. These are very, very important. UPSC previous year question, you always take care of that. Current affair based questions and full length mock test. These, at least, if not the first one, but leave these four things, you should not miss any of these, right? You should not miss any of these, right? And in our prelims marathon, we will take care of this. In the first week, we are already giving this topic-wise conceptual MCQ on a daily basis. Then we are asking you to solve the UPSC previous year question, and we will discuss the important questions in the evening, today evening, and on various days. Current affair based questions we will be giving when we I'll come to the current affair of the economy in the targets, and full length test we will be taking in the phase 2 and phase 3. So we are taking care of everything in our prelims marathon batch so that you don't miss out on anything. Now, some of the pitfalls. Don't try to cram irrelevant facts, irrelevant concept, right? So there are certain concepts which are in news, and you have to differentiate whether this is important for the UPSC or not, because everything which is there in the financial sector is not part of the UPSC syllabus. There are so many free videos available. So you try to engage in various videos, you try to follow various videos, and in the process you left more confused. So rather follow one source, right? Then you try to cover multiple books. You have Ramesh Singh, you have Shriram, you have Murunal. And at the end of the day, if I give you the previous year question, you are confused. So what is the benefit of having multiple book if you are not having the conceptual depth? Then some people recommend Business Standard or Economic Times. That is a pure wastage of time. Not at all you are supposed to do that. Okay, so bilkul bhi aapko karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Aapko sirf aur sirf karne ki zarurat kya hai? Basic conceptual depth. फॉलो सिंगल सोर्स, प्राइमरी बुक पढ़िए आप, करंट अफेयर को फॉलो कीजिए, एंड अप्लाई योर माइंड, सॉल्व द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, पेशेंस रखो, प्रैक्टिस करो, रिवाइज करो, और लिंकिंग ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट विद द करंट अफेयर्स इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.